Kalit Mashile, and today I want to talk a little bit about a video that I saw on Facebook that cracked me up when I read it. And the Facebook post is by Ntibaleng Mokoena. It is absolutely funny. I've kind of summarized it and I'm calling it Mjolo Tax, right? So basically, she talks about why some of us at our age, at our big age of 30, are still not married. You guys know that I recently turned 30, so the questions about marriage and children are coming in thick and fast from every single angle. I get told, Guti, how can a beautiful girl like me not be married? And I'm just like, I didn't know that marriage was, beauty was a qualification for marriage. But that's a story for another day. So let's get back to Mjolo Tax. Remember that none of my videos constitute as financial advice. If you are looking for financial advice, please do consult a registered financial planner who is registered and certified, please. So anyway, what is Mjolo Tax? Let's talk about this. She says, stop going to Baporofeta, stop going to Baruti, stop going to the churches to try and find out what is actually happening in your life, why you're not getting married, and start consulting your family, because your family could be part of the problem. They could be imposing Mjolo Tax on your person without you even knowing it. Like, I was just like, wow, actually, a little bit of truth to this. Maybe not just a little. Maybe a whole lot of truth to this, because I've seen it happen and I've probably participated into taxing my sister's boyfriend or my cousin's person or my whoever's person, and I've been part of this conversation and I'm just like, So this is how it goes. She says, you meet this beautiful man, this lad who's got a good job, who's got a car, he does everything, and 2 months into the relationship, you guys are having the best time of your life. Like, it's Teresa, you're going to getaways, you know, he's taking you out, he's buying you gifts, and your family is watching all this and they're like, Pela, this one, nkare onalisi kweche, onalisi samtinyana. And immediately they put him under a highlighter or they put a spotlight on him and they're like, this is the right one for us. So while you guys are in these good times, you know, love is still pink, your hearts are still pumping custard, your poor person is being highlighted and earmarked for Mjolo Tax. So what is Mjolo Tax? Number one, your family immediately after 2 months have already started calling this person Sbari, son-in-law, Sbariwetu, Mukhonyana wa rona. What is that? I mean, can your family just chill? Sbari, already in 2 months, they need to chill. But here's the problem with calling him Sbari. Calling him Sbari automatically means that they can now start asking for things. Whew. Our families, guys, our families are part of the problem. Hey, they bump into him in the streets. Here's your sister's talking about the next trip that's coming up for her son, your nephew, and how he needs mpaonyana, some money for parkos. And then there's your brother bumping into him at the car wash, asking him to just pay for his car, you know, because we family. Your family's busy asking him, when you're at the family functions, they're busy asking him, Sbari, don't you just want to quickly go there? And I'm just like, this is true. This is true, guys. Even your friends, when you're at your house, there your man is coming there to have a chill session at your house, and your friends are already calling him Sbari, and they're only saying, Sbari, I'm just tangling ice. Go buy some ice for us, or go buy. Please, can you bring back this? Can you bring back that? Guys, we need to stop, eh? We want these people to be able to pay ilobola. We want these people to actually secure a financial life and a financial future for us. But already within 2 months, this poor man is already being taxed. It's no wonder they run away and they don't marry us, guys, because we are taxing them. We are imposing Mjolo Tax on them. And it's wrong, because how then can they grow for it? For us as a unit, if already as from the initial stages, already they are feeling the pinch with your family. There he is at a family function around the bra. You guys are having chats. What does your Malumi do? Your poor man is taking out his last cigarette. What does your Malumi do? It's about escape that. So, with his macabre, escape that. So, relax, Malumi. Please, Malumi, can you calm down? Some of your Malumis actually have the nerve to say, let's drink you. Let's taste you. How are you tasting, my man, through alcohol? I don't understand. Like, it doesn't make sense. Hey, this body must come back with a bottle. Hey, he hasn't even come to even make it. This man probably doesn't even want to marry you already. He's just like, I am out of this. I don't have to pay any of these things. And he literally runs away. So, guys, please, if you're going to be dating somebody, make sure that your family is in line in terms of trying to tax your person, because it ain't right, guys. It actually just does not make financial sense for your family to already be taxing a person 2 months into your relationship. Already this poor person is feeling it. So let's watch it, guys.